Hey folks, Jeremy Schaefer here. All right, now the model that you've all been waiting for. Dun da da da. The flasher sphere. Ready, set, here goes. All right, so we're gonna start out by folding a 16 by 16 grid. So that means we fold in half and then in fourths and in eighths and finally in sixteenths. Fold the edges to the sides. All right, and turn over and fold this edge to the middle. And same thing over here. Turn over and fold in half. Okay, we have divided the paper into 8. Now we're going to divide it into 16. So, all right, let's turn it over and fold this edge right to this crease. And this, fold it to this crease. And again right here. And the raw edge. Okay, rotate and fold this edge right up to here. And do the same thing on the next two flaps. Fold the raw edge up. Alright, now we're going to fold 2 units up, 1 unit down. 2 units up and 1 down. 2 up, 1 down, and turn it over and fold in half. Alright, so we have divided it into 16. Now let's do it in the other direction. So here we go. Fold it in half, and then fourths, eighths, and sixteenths. Alright, so now we have a 16 by 16 grid, but we actually only need a 15 by 15 grid. So let's fold this edge behind, and let's fold the this edge. Now, if you had a diagonal in your square like I did, it should go from corner to corner. Let's make that diagonal. And let's make the other diagonal. This way we can find the center of the square. All right, so here we have the center of the square. So let's make a square of mountain poles. All right, so we have our square of mountains. That's the center. Now what we're going to do is fold this corner to the very last crease right here, but just fold from the middle to the right. Okay, now the same thing here. We're gonna repeat three times. Alright, so here we have our middle square, and we're going to continue this mountain fold right here, all the way out to the side. And let's continue this mountain fold to the side. See, I have my hand below for support. And this mountain fold. And this mountain fold. Okay, so now we're just gonna sort of push it together a little bit. See? And now let's reverse this crease right here. All right, so this is a valley. Now we're gonna make the next segment as a mountain. So just pinch as a mountain, and now make that mountain go right here, all the way to the side, and from here, all the way to the side. All right, so we have the valley and the mountain, and now let's push it together. This. Okay, so we have a valley. Now let's make another mountain. And what we're doing is we're just pleating this back and forth. You see, there's the mountain, mountain, mountain. Now valley. And mountain. And there it is. And now we have to do that three more times. And the last time. right, now we just have to push it together and make this simple fashion. Like that. All right, so here is a simple flasher. And you could stop there, but if you really want to make the flasher sphere, and here goes, okay. All right, so what we're gonna do to make the spherical flasher is we're going to make little pleats that will create a curvature on this plane. So, what we do is we're going to first make a mountain fold between this point and this point. Like that. And now you're just going to make a little little valley right below it. I'm gonna zoom in. Okay. So here's the mountain fold, and then the valley fold is right below it, and just flatten it and squeeze it together. Alright. Now we're going to make this as a mountain fold, and same thing. Now the angle, if this is a larger angle, it'll create more curvature. So you kind of have to experiment, because I don't have the exact mathematics on how to get an exact sphere, but you'll have to either adjust it or just trial and error to get the right curvature. But that's close, I think, I hope. Okay. And now, do the same thing on this one. You see, so here's our square. Here's the middle square. So we started at this corner of the middle square, and we went diagonal, then we turned to here, and we turned to here, and now we're gonna continue right to here. And now, we're going to go from here to here. Like that. And from here, across to here. We're creating this spiral bit that will end up at the edge of the paper. Here to here. All right, let's zoom out. All right, so what we did, the path that we took, here's the center square. We went there to here, to here, to here. The diagonal there, there, there. There, there, there. Now we're going to do that 3 more times. So, see, we already came out this corner. Here's our center square. Let's go out this corner. Spiral. Now the third one. So we've already gone out here and gone out here. Now we have to go out here. Here, here, here. Now let's go out here. Thank you. All right. So we have all the pleats in. Now we just need to bring it together. So here goes. We just need to try to remake the flasher, but incorporating those little folds that we just made. So we could start at the corner, maybe. Here's the center. Thank you. shape. Dunk it in water, and of course tie a rubber band around it, dunk it in water, hold it out in the sun, and it'll try to spring back. It'll spring back a lot easier. All right, and there it is. The flasher sphere. Ooh, look, it's a ball. All right, well, hope you had some luck at that, and yeah, it's kind of tough to fold, but it's pretty neat. It can also be a genie hat or a boxing glove. All right. Later, guys.